Next stop. Navigate to Oak Creek Supercharger. That's loading. Just a few too many people in this parking lot to go messing around with full self-drive over here. And voice command did not work. Navigate to Oak Creek Supercharger. Seems there's a buggy cellular connection today. Nothing again. Navigate to Oak Creek Supercharger. I wonder if a tower's down. Just in the interest of safety, I am going to get us through this intersection due to the amount of construction, and then we will turn on full self-drive. Safety scores anymore. All right, full self-drive active. Wow. Very aggressive turning. The on-ramp. Car's got us locked in at 40 miles per hour. All right, manually. Adjust the speed up. All right, let's see what it does. I turned on navigate on autopilot this time. Looks like that is what happened. So just a quick explanation. Since it's on navigate on autopilot, not full self-drive, I'm going to chop out a bit of this video and shorten it a bit. Now, apparently what happens with full self-drive beta, I can confirm now, once you're on the freeway, there's no more full self-drive. You got to switch over to navigate on autopilot. And I previously had that turned off because even with navigate on autopilot, my safety score would get dinged. But with navigate on autopilot off, and just regular autopilot, it did not. Which we were going to stop at the Oak Creek Supercharger and also pick up some meatballs at the grocery store there. We are instead going to make hamburgers, and we have hamburger meat at home. So we are exiting on Rawson Avenue. And there is going to be a construction zone up ahead, and we'll see how it handles that. I have a feeling it's going to be like playing a game of Pac-Man, only without hitting them with all the cones through the construction zone. Exciting. 3, 2, 1, green arrow. Bing! Nobody behind me. Gives me a little leeway. Not in the first lane. Nope, that's the wrong lane. You should have turned straight into this lane. Nice try, though. It was a good try. We're right by UPS Major Distribution Center, so there's going to be a lot of trucks coming in and out over here. Got UPS right next to us now. Now the backup camera, which you guys cannot see, is completely covered in water from the rain we drove through. The side marker cameras pointing back, which are in the turn signal markers, are clear though. And I'm guessing the pillar cameras, this is what I can see of the A-pillar cameras, looks clear as well. Alright, now, original speed limit's 40, although they lowered it for the construction zone. So it should limit us down to 35 speed limit with a max of 40. And here we go. And you can tell by the blurry lines that FSD is completely confused. Well, not confused, but not very confident. Remember, the sharper the line or the image, the more confidence it has. And since part of the road's all torn up. Now, normally in this situation, I'd go all the way to the right lane, which ends. So you gotta move over quickly. Now, given that this is a Tesla, that's never really been a problem. But given we're testing out full self-drive, look at all those lanes. We actually have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lanes. On our side, 3 on the other side. Because there's 2 left turn, 2 right turn, and 3 straight. So far, not too bad. It even saw the lines on that intersection. Okay, I'm manually accelerating past that turning vehicle. Since there are just way too many cars to sit and let the car, our car, think about it. Now, eventually, we're going to have to be in the right lane. Upcoming lane change and then it would disappear right away. Should start considering it now. There's an opening. I need to program FSD to give it further in advance to make certain lane changes. Now it's slowing down. I'm going to manually, I'm disengaging. That guy just flipped us off. Save that to my Tesla cam. Now, I'm pretty sure the Saturn doesn't have full self-drive. There we go, he finally went. Not too bad. And our car was going to slam right into the back of that Jeep that did not have his emergency flashers on. Would have been bad. City of Franklin. To slow down to nothing. We should be turning here. Alright, let's see how it handles. Why are we going on the right side to make a large swinging left-hand turn? That would have been not very good because usually people are going to pass you on the right while you're making your left so they don't have to stop, especially going downhill. You can see all the cars in the parking lot for the apartment buildings. Not too shabby. I'm still surprised how well it handled all those parked cars on the way going. Headlights just turned themselves on. Good. Coming up to a stop sign. Alright, let's see how this four-way stop has handled again. Rolling stop. I thought Tesla did a software update to get rid of the rolling stops. I'm not disagreeing. I like the rolling stops. Okay, who doesn't drive with a rolling stop? Pretty much everybody drives with a rolling stop. Alright, dude, we got sidewalks for a reason. It drives me absolutely batshit bonkers when people keep walking in the road, blocking cars, when we have a perfectly good sidewalk. A little bit too fast again for the curve. What's our speed? 28? Oh, Jeannie's got visitors. Probably her lady friends for card day. One of our elderly neighbors we help out. And there's the Model S. Let's see what it does. And it's just going to stop us in the middle of the road. And that's it. We are home. Choo-choo. You won a box card. Okay, that was drive number 4 with full self-drive.